What's happening, everyone? Welcome to the world's greatest podcast. It's Ready, Steady, Remake. I'm your host, Rich Kelly, and as always, I'm joined by the greatest human alive. It's Rachel Tomo Thompson.
Cowabunga, dudes!
Cowabunga!
It's gone in again, mate. It's gone in again. I might even put in the whole Turtles. Guys, here's the whole Ninja Turtles theme.
Leonardo leads Donatello dust machines.
That's a fact, Jack.
Raphael is cool, but rude.
Give me a break.
Michelangelo is a party dude.
Welcome to the show. It's Ready, Steady, Remake. We're back. Each week we take a film, we love it, we hate it, and then we remake it. Tomo, what film are we doing this week?
This week, guys, we are doing a movie. It's 1993 American comedy sports film directed by John Turtletaub.
No, that's not his name, is it?
Yeah, mate.
John Turtletaub.
Yeah.
Tremendous.
T-A-U-B. Wouldn't be Taub. Taub.
I don't know. Guys, here's some more Ninja Turtles for Turtletaub.
Tonight I dine on turtle soup.
The soundtrack was by Hans Zimmer.
Didn't Big Bad Jazz. Mate, Hans Zimmer's CV is massive. That fella's just been doing films forever.
Mate. And it's cracking. It's starring Leon Robinson, Doug E. Doug, Raul D. Lewis, Malik Yoba, and of course, the one and only John Candy. On a budget of $17 million, it went on to gross $154.9 million. Loosely based on real-life events, this movie quickly became a cult classic. Feel the rhythm, feel the rhyme. Get on up, it's bobsled time!
Mate, runnings. It's cool runnings.
Woo! It's to follow your dreams.
Follow your dreams.
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
I am feeling very Olympic today.
A story for anyone who dares to stand out in a crowd.
I didn't come up here to forget who I am and where I come from.
And everyone with the courage...
Cool runnings!
To stand up for their dreams.
How will I know if I'm enough? When you cross that finish line.
Where did these guys come from?
Jamaica!
You'll know.
Cool runnings.
Rach, we've got a long history with this film. When we were at university, for some reason, this was like... we had a friend called Jag. This was kind of always in the background, always being quoted. Kiss my lucky egg. It was a thing. But... do you remember the first time you ever saw Cool Runnings, Rach?
I can't remember, mate. I just can't remember. And I think maybe it's because, as you just said, when we were in uni and when we hung out with Jag, like after uni, it was just forever on. It was just like part of our like existence. So, yeah, I genuinely can't. I was like scratching the old ball bag. You know I love that saying, mate.
Yeah, mate, you got to tickle the old bollocks every once in a while.
Scratching the old ball bag, trying to think back. But, yeah, I've got nothing, mate. I've literally got nothing other than it's just one of the best movies ever. And I watched it the other week, knowing that we were going to do this. I'm so glad you chose this movie, mate. It's so good.
It's brilliant.
It's so colourful and beautiful and funny. It's so funny, mate. It's
funny as hell. Mate, I saw this film at the pictures. When I was
did
a little, yeah. I remember seeing Cool Runnings at the movies and like loving it as a little kid. It was really popular though. I remember it being like a big summer film. I'm sure it was like a big hit in the UK as well.
I can't remember.
Yeah, man, this was a big movie. I remember seeing it with all my family, my brothers, and like we loved it. But yeah, it's Cool Runnings. It's amazing. So let's get into it, mate. Let's get into the juice of Cool Runnings. First of all, I want to talk a little bit about the casting in this film. Let's start with John Candy.
But realistically, only a fool would put their money on Tumbleweed. That horse had no chance of...
That guy won 2 gold medals?
He's such a giant force in this film. He's kind of the biggest name in it. the main guy, the main Jamaican sprinter. The only thing I know him from was he played the Black Jesus in Madonna's music video for Like a Prayer. There's a Jesus statue who comes alive and it's him. But John Candy's in this. It was one of the last films he made before his sad early demise.
Yeah, I think it was literally like months afterwards.
I know that he died during the filming of a movie that I remember renting. Him and Emilio Estevez. It's called something like Wagons East or Coaches West. I can't remember what it's called. But he died during that. And I think this was the film that he made previous to that film.
Yeah, yeah.
Mate, John Candy's amazing. And in this, he plays not only is he the straight man, but he's also quite like a tortured and dark character.
Mm, when you first meet him, like, he looks like shit. Do you know what I mean? Like, he's like he's had a rough ride. Do you know what I mean? He's got his sunglasses on, his hair's all greasy, and he's a bit bitter.
Sweating, mate.
Yeah, sweating so much sweat, bitter and angry. Do you know what I mean? Just a bit grumpy old John Candy. But then, as you know, the movie just ignites him again, and he just gets his fire.
But I'm thinking of the stuff like the fact that he cheated back in the day. Yeah. And when he goes and has that big speech with the board, when he walks in and he's like, he's like, don't take it out on me. These guys deserve a chance to support their country and all that. It's fucking moving, man.
Those guys have earned the right to represent their country. They've earned the right to march into that stadium and wave their nation's flag. That's the single greatest honor an athlete could ever have. That's what the Olympics are about. 16 years ago, I forgot that. Don't you go and do the same.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I think of John Candy, I think of Uncle Buck and friggin' Ghostbusters. Not Ghostbusters, sorry, but he's what's the one that he's in?
He's in Home Alone as well.
He's a polka. He's in a terrible film that I used to watch as a kid. What's it called? About the couple who get trapped and have to go to court. And I'll roll a clip and I can put what it's called in this bit. I'll have it flash on the screen. All right. Or I'll think about it in a couple of minutes and it'll just come out. It's called like Nowhere to Hide. But Demi Moore's in it. Chevy Chase is in it. Oh. Dan Aykroyd is a big judge who's got a dick for a nose. He actually does. He has a dick on his nose.
Can't think of what it is.
Nothing but trouble.
No.
I got it.
You fucking got it.
Nothing but trouble, mate. John Candy's in that. That was it.
All of that for that.
But mate, yeah, John Candy, he's great. And like I say, sadly,
is his name in this? What's John Candy's name?
Blitz.
That's it. I've got it here.
Herb Blitz.
Ev Blitzer. And do you know what it means in Norway? Do you know what the translation is?
No.
Cold buttocks.
Cold arsehole.
Cold ass.
No, what? Yeah. That's mad. Now, the thing is, right, I'm trying my best to not talk about the actual reality of what happened, because that's gonna come up later on. So I'm just gonna kind of with the history of things. So I'm just gonna stick to like the film for the time being. All right.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think about it, mate, when it comes to like the portrayal of Jamaica in this? How do you think? One thing that I find strange, and I'm not having a go or anything, I'm just like, there's no Jamaican actors in the main four fellas.
Yeah, I know. Because I think probably when I watched it when I was younger, I didn't really think about it. But yeah, watching it the other night, yeah, I was a bit like, is this like a really, American stereotypical, like, portrayal of Jamaica? Like, this is, everything's colourful and everyone's, like, all the accents are quite over the top. I don't know. I'm not Jamaican. So, as a Jamaican person, would they have a different, would they be like, that's not what it's fucking like? Do you know what I mean? I don't know.
I think the thing is, though, it's such, it paints Jamaica in such a lovely light that I think you'd struggle to find anything negative about it. Mm. I mean, it makes me want to go to Jamaica. Like,
mate, 100%.
Just, do you know what I mean? And especially when, or it's the town are like watching it on the little telly in the bar at the end, and they're all like, Jamaica!
Where did these guys come from?
Jamaica!
Yes!
I went out after I watched the movie, and obviously the sun's been cracking the flags lately. I went and got some red stripe beers. That's all they drink through the film. And I was watching the movie going, I just want to sit in the sun in that sweet-ass bar with the fucking, the Olympics on, cheering with all the locals, drinking Red Stripe. That's what I want.
Gotta rise above it. It's such a happy vibe. I mean, listen, it's definitely been Hollywoodized. Is that even a word? I don't think so. It's definitely seen through a Hollywood lens. Even to the extent of having the typical cliche villain team who are like, fuck you, Jamaica.
Yeah, it's so over the top.
Swiss. I think they're Swiss. Yeah,
oh, like, fuck you, Jamaica.
Home, Jamaica. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, they actually call them all Jamaica, don't they?
Yeah, mate. But then at the end, they're like, Jamaica, you did us proud or whatever. Yeah. They're like, good going, Jamaica.
We love you, Jamaica.
Yeah. Eins, zwei, drei. Because you make some, like, yeah, man.
But apparently in the real life, because it's based on a true story, isn't it?
Yeah.
But apparently it was quite the opposite. Like, it was loosely based on a true story. Apparently the Swiss were like, and everyone who was in the competition were like open arms, welcoming it.
Apparently, listen, we'll just go into it. Everyone apparently was sound and loved Jamaica, mate. Like, the story goes as well, that I understand why they didn't do this in the movie, but this is something that I'll go into later on in my remake. Really, the team was formed by two American fellas. It was two white American guys who were in a bar somewhere, who were like watching a video of the Jamaican push cart championships.
Okay.
During their push the cars down the hill.
Well, that's and how it starts, doesn't it? The movie.
So these two American fellas were like, we've got an idea. Let's see if they'd be good in a bobsled. Now, they didn't go and actually find a bunch of push sled fellas or like running athletes or anything like that. They went to the Jamaican Special Forces and went to the army, mate. That's where they went. And they got three fucking badass Jamaican young soldiers and were like, you boys, we've got an idea for you, right? So they took three of these lads and they went to train them, and I think it's Vancouver where they went to train. And they were like, in the film, they get something like 6 months to train. In real life, it was like 7 weeks. But like, they literally turned up and were like, we're going to the Olympics, get in your bobsled. And then when they arrived at the Olympics, something to do with they had fucked up the number of people in the team, and they'd applied for a four-man race when they only had three men. So they had 3 days to find another member of the team. And they found some athlete lad who was a runner at a local university who was Jamaican and got him in it. And he hadn't seen a bobsled in his life and then competed in the Olympics 3 days later in a bobsled.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And then also another thing they cut out of the film was something like after 7 weeks on the first trial that they ever had, they came in seventh out of like 20, but they cut that from the movie because people were like, it's too unbelievable how amazing they were straight away.
Mate, you should have made that film.
Yeah.
Also, Special Armed Forces.
Yeah, well, we'll get into that later.
Yes.
Also the crash. They actually show the crash in the film.
Yeah, that's real footage, isn't it?
Yeah, when their heads are like, that is the real footage, man.
Oh, and he's getting all over the place in the Kreisel. Oh, and he's on there, he's over! Oh, dear me! Oh, that's terrible. Oh, that's a bad crash, I'm afraid.
The ending, though, isn't the same. Like, they didn't carry it on their own while everyone, like, clapped in solidarity and the walking fella went to America. Yeah, they did walk it along.
Oh, did they?
But,
okay.
Yeah, but you kind of have to do that to get it off.
Yeah.
But it wasn't just the team. It was loads of other people who came and moved it.
Oh, right.
And they didn't carry it on their shoulders like that either.
I wish, though.
But that ending...
Mate, and they all come together. Mate, whenever there's a slow clap in it, and you're like, here we go. And the music, Hans Zimmer's music's awesome in it.
Mate, it is awesome. Well, I love that tune. You gotta rise above it. Also, the one tune we have to talk about is Sanka's incredible reggae number. Some people say they can't believe Jamaica, we got a bobsled team.
Yes! Now,
I'm sure I used to remember the whole thing from uni. Something like,
you did. You
the one Marie Sander, one your banner, and the faster, Sander faster, the faster Jamaican sprinter. I forget what it is, but Jack used to sing it every day, mate. Every day.
Every day. We should have had him on this show, actually, when I think about it.
It would have been great to have a little guest spot from Jag doing his...
Guest spot. He would have sang all of the... He would have been quoting it so much, mate.
Kiss my lucky egg, mate. I see pride. I see power. I see a badass mother who don't take a no crap off of nobody.
Yes!
I see pride!
Junior!
I see power! I see a badass mother who won't take no crap off of nobody!
That's me!
Yes, mate.
It's a big moment when he says that to his dad. And then his dad's there at the end. He's one of the clappers. And
he pulls his top open. Yes! He's got a Jamaica t-shirt on.
It's even when the commentary fellas as well, they've both got them on.
Yeah, they're like, hey, we all feel the Jamaican spirit. And then he cuts that pub and they're like, Jamaica!
Jamaica!
I love it.
If I can get a clip of that pub going Jamaica is going to be in this video every 10 seconds, just flying out, mate.
Jamaica!
But yeah, this is a great sports film as well. I'm not a big sports guy, mate. You know me.
And me too.
I don't watch any of that football shit, guys. I like movies. That's why I do this podcast. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I've been getting into lately, though, when we're talking about sports? NFL, mate.
American Football League.
Mate, I am in it. I've been watching... The new season starts in September, and I've literally been watching NFL Super Bowl reruns every Sunday. I have a Super Bowl Sunday now, and I'm just watching old Super Bowls. Mate, I love it.
What? That's
mental.
What got you into that?
I watched the Super Bowl this year for the first time, and my dad explained the rules to me. And now that I know what the hell's going on, I'm in it, mate. I follow them on Instagram and everything.
Shit, la.
I know.
Impressive.
I'm a fan.
I've not been in. I mean, the only thing I watch a lot of boxing, and I watch a lot of MMA. But mainly that's because my girlfriend loves boxing. I know it's weird. My girlfriend's obsessed with filthy boxing. Like, she loves two sweaty fellas just having it out. So, there you go. What can I say? honest to God, she makes me stay up till 4 a.m. to watch boxing. I know. So, mate, this is Cool Runnings. I mean, I don't think there's anything more we can say about it. Is there really?
Only thing that we can say about it, I don't know if you know, Rich, before we move on, do you know who auditioned for this film? No. Tupac
Shakur.
Yeah.
But you know what? That makes sense. It's around this time. He's around this time. He's doing it. Do you know something mad?
What?
That is mental. The first film Tupac was ever in is Nothing But Trouble, that movie that I was struggling to think about earlier on. Mad things, mate.
Mad things.
Tupac is in that movie. It's his first ever film.
That's mad.
Yeah, mate, that is mad. Nothing But Trouble, guys. If you've never seen it, Dan Aykroyd has a dick for a nose. Easy clip of it. It was in there, mate. I put it in again. All right, mate.
Cool Runnings. Loved it. Watch it.
It's been a journey. Cool Runnings. Let's go quickly, mate. Some of the classic lines. Let's call her Tallulah. Tallulah's a whore's name. Tallulah was my mother's name. It's a great line. It's a great line. Kiss my lucky egg. Sanka, what you smoking? I'm not smoking, I'm breathing. That was always
one of my favorite. Yeah, what was the other one when they're in and he crashes? Are you Sanka, you're dead? Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. You'll burn out. I'll draw a line down your head and make it look like a butt.
Yes, yeah, that's my favourite. Man,
that's a good one. That's a my good favourite. One. When your Brenner goes, one day I'm gonna live here and pulls out a photo of Buckingham Palace and they all go take the piss out of him and he gets dead upset. I love that bit as well. It's a good movie. It's a fucking good movie.
It's a great movie. And it's a good summer movie.
He's giving out
movie.
Three kisses. He's giving out three kisses. And there's this old woman with no teeth.
The old woman, because the girlfriend comes along and he has to get off. And then the old woman, and he's like, Sanka's
out. Sanka gets on and he's like, hey. And then he's like, ah. Oh, mate, it's a good fucking movie. There's a reason people watch it. Watch it all the time. Anyway. All right, mate.
Right, should we move on to top 10?
Guys, we're moving on to Tomo's top 10 internet hits.
You've got a problem, you're about to rise above it.
So, this week, guys, Tomo's top 10 favourite sports movies. Now, I don't really watch many sports movies. Well, I didn't think I did, but this is my version of it.
You've done it again. Is this yours? This is yours.
This is my top 10, mate.
All right, now, going off your top 10, I can already think of some that will probably be in there. But the truth is, sports knowledge is one of my gaps in movie film knowledge.
Yeah, yeah.
So we'll see if I've got any information for you on them.
We'll see where we go. And if there's some that you want to throw in. So coming at number 10 is Dodgeball.
Mate.
It's a sports movie, mate.
What an incredible choice.
Ben Stiller, Vince Vaughn.
I don't know. Because when that kind of, what were they called? They were called the Frat Pack. Like Will Ferrell, Vince Vaughn, Ben Stiller, Owen Wilson. Those movies were massive when we were kind of in our formative years. Have they dated? Do you think young people would still watch Dodgeball and go, this is hilarious? Or is it, I don't know anymore.
Because I think it's hilarious.
Yeah, like, it's a metaphor, but it really happened. It's a good movie.
Love that movie. Number 10.
Dodge a ball, you can dodge a wrench. It's a good film.
Mate, it's awesome. And it's just classic Ben Stiller, just being all with his moustache. Do you want a mate? Do you want a date? I've just been sick in my mouth. Number 9, Happy Gilmore.
Mate, you're pulling golf. It out with the old comedies, aren't you? It is golf, mate.
Again, it's that time, isn't it? It's our kind of time.
Yeah, I love Happy Gilmore. I remember renting Happy Gilmore on VHS with my brothers, and we were crying at how funny that for the film was. When Happy Gilmore opened the box and it was the alligator's head. And then at the end, when it cuts to Carl Weathers, he's in heaven on the piano and stuff. Mate, we were crying. We thought it was the funniest thing in the world.
Mate, it's so good. Yeah. It's so good. Number 8, I've gone for Nacho Libre wrestling. Jack Black.
I've got a feeling that we saw that at the pictures together.
I think we did, mate.
I think you, me and Az went to see that at the pictures. I've got a feeling that we saw that at the movies together. I haven't seen it since then.
No, I haven't.
I'll be honest with you. I remember not liking it in the pictures.
Did you not?
I don't think I did.
I don't think it's his best.
I haven't seen it since.
I don't think it's his best Jack Black. I think there's it's because he's a monk, isn't he? He's a monk
and he's got a secret identity of being a luchador. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I need to watch it again.
Yeah, watch it again, mate.
Number seven.
Now, I don't know if you've seen, you don't really watch sports stuff. Now, this is a genuinely good film. It is Moneyball. Have you heard of it?
No. I've got to put it on front street, guys. This film has an incredible reputation. It's the story of baseball statistics and stuff, isn't it?
So it's got
an incredible cast.
Yeah, Brad Pitt's the coach. And then Jonah Hill basically comes in and he changes the kind of whole process to taking on players. So rather than just, he computer puts it into the computer.
They use like programs and stuff, don't they?
Yeah, it's like a computer generated system where they kind of like, so they're not necessarily on like, you know, like the best players, but for some reason he creates like a format in this computer that it will just work. So it's kind of to save money, and in the end this team's like unreal.
Now this is the thing, right? I think this is Aaron Sorkin as well who wrote this.
Yeah.
Really
good,
it's
mate.
It's either Aaron Sorkin or fucking what's his name, Tomo? What's his name? Massive fucking playwright in America. David Mamet.
I thought it was Aaron Sorkin.
It must be Aaron Sorkin. I've always heard nothing but good things about it, but the fact about baseball has always put me off. Are you telling me? I've never seen it.
Mate, it's
It's on Netflix. I can watch it now. But
I thought like a genuinely, and like, don't get me wrong, like baseball is very much a part of it, but it's more about kind of like this process of like what he does, and it and kind of fucks it up, and people think like he's like, you know, he's a madman. What the hell is he doing? Why is he like changing things up? They've never done this in baseball before, and it's one of those classic like underdog stories where you're like, you're rooting for them, and it kind of.
Mate, by next show we do, I'm going to give you my little quick review of Moneyball. Yeah. I will have watched it. I'll let you know what I think.
Yeah, I recommend it.
I'll definitely check it out, mate, 100%. Now you've done that, I will.
So, number 6, Remember the Titans.
Is that Al Pacino?
No, it's...
No, it's Any Given Sunday. Is Al Pacino.
Denzel Washington, mate.
Yeah,
so again, this is NFL. A really good movie, mate, because this is based on a true story. I watched this last year, I think. And basically, it actually happened. I don't know where it was. I think it's Baltimore, maybe. But for like back in the day, for forever, the NFL teams was always white or black. Do you know what I mean? It was never mixed. And it basically, this African American coach came in to take over a team. They were all fuming with him, and it's the whole like, you know, separate buses, you know, separate like areas to coach. And he goes, fuck this, no, I'm going to mix the best players. And it's all about the journey, about how these, you know, African-American players and white players are having to kind of train together, and they're fighting, and it's all kicking off, and it's not happening, it's not working. And once again, as they kind of bond and become tighter and tighter, they become like this fucking ultimate team, and they just respect and love one another. And it's awesome, mate. It's a true story.
I feel like I might have seen it, but maybe I haven't.
Mate, it's good.
I'd know if I'd seen it. I'd know. I'm going to have to watch it, mate. You're crushing me today. I'm embarrassed I haven't seen the films, Tomo. And I do a podcast about films.
Well, the next lot, I'm pretty sure you've seen all of them.
I hope so. I don't want to be embarrassed again, mate.
How did I embarrass you?
You've shown me up.
Shown me up.
Shown me up.
Shown me up.
Polish me little head there, mate. Sign it up, mate.
Shown me up. Number 5, it's Cool Runnings, mate, so we don't need to speak much about that.
Tremendous.
Cool Runnings. Number 4 is Raging Bull, De Niro.
I watched Raging Bull again the other night. It's been on ITV a lot recently. And I watched it the other night. I thought, you know what? I'm going to sit down, I'm going to watch Raging Bull. Still great. Holds up. It's good fucking movie.
It's filmed great, isn't it? Yeah, it looks boss. Number 3, A League of Their Own. League of Their Own, mate, just like a bunch of like really like awesome women, funny actors coming together, ruling the roost. So that's my number 3. And as...
Is Tom Hanks in it? Is Tom Hanks on the team of the fellas? I need to look into A League of Their Own, mate. I'm either confusing like 10 different films altogether.
There's a Kevin Costner film, Field of Dreams.
Field of Dreams is amazing. I know Field of Dreams.
No, I don't think Tom Hanks is in this. It's the one where they're all like, they all get, and they all come from like different like strokes of life, and they all get on the bus, and they all come together, and they build a female baseball team.
Yeah, mate. I know the one you mean.
Look it up. What's her name? Get it.
All right, so get on this, lad.
Gina Davis.
The lead. And Tom Hanks is in it.
Okay.
I have seen it. I've definitely seen it. And Madonna is in it as well.
Yeah.
I have seen it. I'm mixing it up with several different movies, though. I was thinking of the one when Goldie Hawn joins the army.
No, what's that?
Private Benjamin.
That's a great movie, mate.
Sorry, mate. Guys, if you listen, we just went on the worst tangent we've ever been on the show. I don't know what just happened there, mate. From trying to think of Gina Davis to now, that I don't know what's just happened there.
Mate, I'm going to watch Private Benjamin. I love that film.
It's a good fucking movie, mate. Yeah, it is.
Good movie.
Yeah, man. I watched Death Becomes Her the other morning.
Oh, we need to do that. That's definitely on our... We've got to do Banger.
Yeah. I saw that at the cinema as well. I was like a proper little kid. One of my first ones I ever saw. Watched the other day. It's all about tits and shit. And I was like, how is this a PG? I remember my mum loving it in the cinema and crying, cracking up. And I was like, I don't fucking care.
Yeah, mate. And it was only until like years later, like when I became like an adult, I realised it was fucking Bruce Willis as well.
Mate, I know. Bruce is all like white and like kind of like horrible, was he? And like, anyway, this ain't the episode about Death Becomes Her. Crack on, mate. Sorry.
number two, Rocky, mate. Rocky.
Gotta be in it. It's gotta be in it.
And also, it's like one of the movies that I remember when I first watched it. I think we've done a Rocky episode, haven't we? With Nick.
I don't know if we have.
We did. We got
we did Rocky One, didn't we? Nick Pete was on the episode, Tomo from Fight Disciples.
Yes, he was. Yeah, he was.
I remember it well.
But yeah, I remember when I watched Rocky for the first time and all I did was just want to fucking punch everything. I just had a fight with the pillar, fight with the bed, fight with the wall. Like I loved it. Loved Rocky.
I mean, the thing about Rocky that we talked about in the podcast was people forgot because of the sequels where Rocky became kind of like this real big, I don't want to say goofy, but kind of these big stories. The first Rocky is this small, little, serious
on
drama.
On a budget, mate, it was...
Incredibly well acted, incredibly well written. Rocky's a full-blown masterpiece. I'm surprised it's not number one. I've got a feeling what your number one might be. And if it's anything to do with quacking animals, there's going to be an issue. Carry on, mate.
Coming in at number one. It's the Mighty Ducks, mate.
Fucking mate. Show's over, everyone. Show's over.
Yeah.
Rocky One just got beaten by Mighty Ducks.
And just when you think they're about to break apart,
ducks fly together.
And when the wind blows hard and the sky is black,
ducks fly together.
It's my top 10, mate. Of course. I love that shit, mate. I love the Mighty Ducks. And I've just started watching the new series as well. I love it.
Is it out yet?
Yeah, it's out, mate.
The new Disney one?
It's on Disney Plus. Yeah, mate. I watched the first episode.
Is it out weekly or is it all out already?
I don't know. There's more out now. It was weekly, so yeah, there's a few more out now. But yeah, I've watched the first episode, mate. It's great.
I'm getting on that.
Yeah,
mate.
Emilio Estevez is in it.
Coach Bombay, son.
Yeah, yeah. And he's like classic, like all older, a bit fatter, a bit miserable. Like, I'm not going to coach a team.
I got to put it on Front Street, Tomo. I'm more of a fan of Mighty Ducks 2 than I am Mighty Ducks 1.
Oh, okay.
I like the, they're like the brawler twins in Mighty Ducks 2.
Oh, and yeah.
And they get like the two lads who wear bandanas and look around boshing people.
Yeah, because it's like at the end, like college, is it? It's like a...
No, that's number three, mate, when they go to the university.
Yeah.
Number three is shitty, though. Number three is shitty. Number one's okay. Number two's pretty good. Number three is shitty. That's just my opinion, though.
Yeah. We'll have to do a Mighty Duck special, mate. Tomo.
I knew it. As soon as I realised that Rocky was two, I was like, what else could there possibly be? Oh, no.
That's it, mate. That is my top 10 Tomo's favourite sports movies.
So, mate, you know what time it is, don't you?
What time is it, Rich?
Guys, it's the titular part of the show. It's time to Ready, Steady, Remake. All right, guys, this is it. It's a part of the show where each week, Tomo and myself try to remake a once popular film. Sometimes it proves a lot more difficult than you'd imagine. And this week was especially tough. Tomo, I'm going first to get it out of the gate. Okay?
Do it, mate.
And
go for it.
I'll put effort in when I got notes.
Oh.
So, very simple. The plan is this, right? We're going straight to Disney Plus. Disney funding this motherfucker, right? But this one, it's all about the true story. And not only, it's not a movie. Let me make that clear. This is not a movie. This is a three-part mini-series on Disney Plus. And the show is called Peace Be the Journey, colon, Cool Runnings.
Ooh.
That's the show, Peace Be the Journey, colon, Cool Runnings. And we're going by the strict story. But let me give you my cast first, mate.
Do it,
first
mate.
Of all, it's directed by Ryan Coogler, the man who directed Black Panther and the man who directed Creed. Already he's done a boxing film, the man knows sport. Also, he's a big voice in the black community. I'm going to try my best to tell this story more from the point of view of the Jamaican lads as opposed to kind of whitewashing it, right?
Okay.
But I'm still not going to avoid the facts. So, episode one of Cool Runnings, right? Peace Be the Journey. We meet up with Devin Harris, who was the real guy in real life, played by the great Michael B. Jordan, right? Mm. And Michael B. Jordan, we follow him as he joins the Jamaican Special Forces. And the first episode is all about this guy in the army.
Nice.
And just training in the army. And in the way, he meets the two other fellas who would eventually join the team, played by Oscar-winning Daniel Kaluuya, who won the Oscar last night for Best Supporting Actor.
Yes.
And also, Lakeith Stanfield, who you might know Lakeith from. He's in Get Out.
Yes.
Yeah, he's badass.
Love that guy.
Judas the Black Messiah with Daniel Kaluuya, so also got some chemistry going off there. And it's about them. At the end of the episode, they are poached by two Americans who go, listen, we're looking for you to join the team. So I was thinking, I want two iconic Americans. What fellas can I get? And you know what? It's been a long time. I'm bringing them back. It's Damon and Affleck, mate.
Oh.
Matt Damon and Ben Affleck are back together to play the Americans who get the team together. And
that's
that is
mad.
The end of episode one. That's the end of episode one. Episode two, we go to Vancouver to train. And it's all about the culture clash. These fellas, they've never been in the cold before. Mm-hmm. They've never even seen a bobsled. We can get some comedy out of this. We meet the locals. There's a whole episode about it. We got Matt Damon, it's class. Episode three, the final episode, we go to the Olympics. But of course, we have the introduction of Winston Duke as the fourth man.
yeah.
Winston Duke, he was in Us, Black Panther.
Yeah.
That's our full team together.
Yes. And he's the runner. Point. Is he the runner?
Yeah, he's the brakeman. I think he becomes the brakeman.
Yeah.
No, I think he's the runner. I think Devin Harris was the brakeman. I'm not sure. And that's it, mate. And it ends in the realistic way. It tells the truth. It's a heartwarming, true depiction of that story. Three-part miniseries, Peace Be the Journey, Cool Runnings by Ryan.
Love it, mate. Slow clap.
That's
slow
it, mate.
Slow clap.
You gotta rise above it.
You gotta rise above it.
Yeah, mate.
Love it, mate. Yeah. I mean, as soon as you were telling the real story before, of course, that's what you gotta do. What you gotta
that's
do.
The only way. The only way, I think.
All right,
mate, you
ready for this?
Oh, I'm ready.
So, it's set in a care home, an old people's home, yeah?
Yeah.
And we've got my cast. Here's my cast. I haven't got a director, so if you can think of a director for me, let me know, mate. So as you can imagine, bunch of old people just bumbling around in the care home. One of them's Eddie Murphy.
Already, I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, straight away.
One of them's miserable old Wesley Snipes. So Eddie Murphy's going to be my sanker. Wesley Snipes going to be...
You made Leon the main guy. Yeah. Yul Brynner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Alfonso Ribeiro from is going to be the the smart one. Like,
doesn't want to
let his dad down. But like,
I can't remember his name.
But he's going to be like proper Carlton, like, you know, Dickie Bow or like.
Oh, yeah. Oh, mate, it's Carlton. It's Carlton, is what you're telling me. Yeah,
tremendous. So all like their age now, as I'm saying. And then there's a new guy basically who comes into the care home, and it's Denzel Washington, mate.
And Denzel comes in and goes, I'm looking for the best.
Denzel Washington, who's an ex-runner, basically. He's an ex-runner, and he gets wheeled in, and he's all fucking fuming that, like, he's in this care home, and he starts getting to know all the others, and then the nurse, now this is mad things, mate. There's a nurse who basically looks after them all and keeps them in check, and he's dead fun, and he keeps them going, you know, looks after them all. It's fucking Matt Damon, mate. I chose Matt Damon.
Matt Damon, mate.
So Matt Damon's in, and basically news gets out that there's a local care home resident Olympics. Yeah. And
there's a care home Olympics.
Yeah, chips in, mate.
Smasher.
And Denzel's like, no way. Like, we've got to get in on this. Like, I used to be a runner. And he convinces the nurse to enter, to Matt Damon nurse to enter the four of them into, but they're not, it's not bobsled, it's actual running. So they're going to be a relay team, mate. So that then there's going to be a series of montage of them in the care home, silly stuff, you know, around the care home, practicing running. And then eventually they go and they win the relay team. They win the whole competition. And it's called Fool's Running.
Slow clap, mate. Slow clap. You've done it again, mate. Do you know what, though? I actually quite like it. I actually like the idea of, like, taking the retirees and giving them some kind of... One thing I would change, I wouldn't call it the Olympics. I would maybe say it's like, you know, care homes, entertainment day or something. But I like it. Actually, it's a solid premise.
It could be all right, couldn't it? And it bringing all them faces back. Imagine Wesley Snipes and Eddie Murphy.
Yeah, mate, they've been back.
Carlton.
I feel it. Oh, Carlton is the one that's got, mate. I'm into it, mate. I'm really into it.
So, Fool's Running.
Guys, Fool's Running and Peace Be the Journey. Those were the remakes of today's episode. Tomo, I think that's it, mate.
That's it, mate. It's the end of the show. I thoroughly enjoyed it, mate.
It was good fun, man. It was good fun.
It's been
a while since we did like a frivolous comedy. We've been doing some deep shit recently.
Yeah, we have.
So it's nice just to do some, you know, this ain't Batman. This is just a bit of fucking fun. Mate, that's it.
Thanks for listening. As usual, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Give us a tweet. Give us a little what's happening. Write us a letter. We love our letters, don't we, Rich?
Yeah. We're at Ready Steady Remake on Instagram. Tomo is at
Rachel Tomo. Yeah.
I'm at RichKelly999. Follow us on there. Give us a like and some nudes.
And subscribe on our YouTube channel. We need more subscribers. We've only got about...
We do. We need to figure out the YouTube thing, mate. We need to figure
we're
out...
We're not on it. We don't know how to kind of...
Figure out what we're doing wrong. Get on it.
Yeah, we don't know what we're doing.
I don't know what I'm doing, mate. But I'm still doing it. That's what counts. All right, then. Listen.
Three, two, one.
I'm out of here. 3, 2, 1.
Stay safe.
Enough people say, you know, they can't believe. Jamaica, we have a bobsled team.